Hey, happy Sunday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I got your latest tropical update on what's going on, because not only is it historic now, what's going on with Major Hurricane Beryl, we do have Invest 96L also showing threats with that as well. Now, Invest 94L is still going to be maybe a tropical depression at best, right before landfall, still bringing the flooding. Beryl, now it's at 983 millibars, 92 miles per hour maximum winds. Motion is 21 miles per hour to the west. It is speeding up. Matter of fact, that's the difference between the GFS and the Euro. The GFS and the Canadian both take it to the west faster than the Euro. Also showing with the Euro, maybe it can go all the way towards the western Gulf of Mexico, maybe towards northern Mexico, maybe towards Texas. That's where it's trending at. Also with GFS, also showing that towards Texas. And with the Canadian, it's showing it towards Louisiana. Plus, Invest 96L could turn earlier, or it could go right towards Florida. Now, this is actually historic, what's going on with Hurricane Beryl, because the earliest major hurricane is August 3rd from 1899 from Siriaco. I believe that's the name of that hurricane. It was called the Puerto Rico Hurricane. Very bad. We're at the end of June. This is unheard of territory. And Siriaco went to a Cat 4, and so will Beryl. So I'm going to show you all the latest information in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year long with weather forecasts. I've been covering these waves for a long time. We've been expecting these for about a week now, including Invest 96L. I will show you the latest information. I have links in the description to show you the winds and the rain threat for your area. You can zoom all the way in, free to use. Make sure to share this information to other people. Give them a little heads up, a little alert of what's going on. Because not only is this going by the Lesser Antilles, and they already have hurricane warnings out, also tropical storm, but this is also going right by Dominican Republic and Haiti, possibly going north into Haiti, and going right by Jamaica. Still showing it will be a strong hurricane. Then going by the Cayman Islands as potential still a hurricane and the Yucatan. So I will keep you updated on all this information. I will do afternoon updates like I always do. And you can see the curving that Beryl can potentially take. Matter of fact, latest information just came through showing that Beryl would definitely be a Cat 4 hurricane going towards the Lesser Antilles. 139 miles per hour sustained winds. That's not wind gusts. That's sustained winds. That's wind gusts at least 160. Showing that it will remain a Cat 4 the whole time and going towards Jamaica as a major hurricane. Also for the Western Caribbean, still being a major hurricane. So please keep this in mind. When these storms strengthen, it does help it wobble north a little bit more. Now there is a TUT right here, a upper tropospheric trough, that's putting a little bit of shear. And it was showing some degradation of the tropical wave. But this wave is going to be so strong, it's going to bulldoze right through that, barely weaken down, and then strengthen right back up. Now you can see Beryl strengthening right here in the MDR. And even though it is doing rapid intensification, you still see it has some shear still hitting the eastern side of this. So as soon as that goes away, because it is forecasted to weaken and go away, it will strengthen up some more. So I believe it will stay that strong Cat 4 all the way through. And as you take a look at it, you can see it has a well-defined center right now. A very much rapid intensifying hurricane. Now you can see that Siriaco in 1899 went across Puerto Rico and did go across the Bahamas and right on the eastern side of Florida. That was the previous run of our historical earliest major hurricane, and now it's going to be Beryl. Latest update from National Hurricane Center, you still have Invest 95L, be a tropical depression at best, still going to bring big impacts of flooding that you need to watch out for. Plus you have Invest 96L and you have Hurricane Beryl. And they're showing Invest 96L could be a tropical depression by the middle of the week, maybe a little bit stronger. Latest intensity showing on Invest 96L, it could become one member showing a potential hurricane as it goes 4 days towards the Lesser Antilles right after Beryl goes by, and then maybe going back down towards a tropical storm and maybe something else later down the road. And you can see that right when it reaches that intensity, it will be going towards the Lesser Antilles right past 4 days. And maybe as you go towards 6 days, a tropical storm or stronger could be going towards Jamaica, Haiti, Cuba, or Dominican Republic and going right towards Florida. That's the latest track guidance. We have another one here for you showing potentially could go even further to the west, get into the Gulf, are a couple members showing it could go over Dominican Republic, over towards Bahamas, over towards Haiti, and become over there where Siriaco did actually form. But look, all the members agreeing over here in the Gulf. Now you can see here from your latest shot that after it passes by the Lesser Antilles, it goes towards Jamaica. And what you have is this tut here, this upper tropospheric trough right here. And this was going to put a lot of shear on the system, weaken it down greatly. But as strong as it is, being a Cat 4 breathing well in upper dynamics, it bulldozes right through that shear, weakens down to a major hurricane on our scale so far, and shows potentially going into the Gulf, turning north, while 96L goes right towards Jamaica, and look how it goes north in the Gulf, right towards Texas. Now that's just on this latest run. We still don't know which way this could possibly turn, but you see that the high pressure will move in time. And you can see this here. You have your big high pressure right here, and this is going to move to the east as that goes closer. So it's good timing, and that's why it goes to the western side of the Gulf of Mexico, because you still got the high pressure, but it could easily start turning after that. But on this model run, it stays to the west. Now, when you look at the latest with the Ural, you can see that you have your big dome of high pressure expanding out, keeping everything pushing towards the west. And when you keep going forward, you can see that it stays there and it don't move into the Atlantic fast enough. And it stays along that vicinity and keeps pushing that to the west. Finally, it goes over Florida. Then it starts curving up northward towards Mexico, potentially towards southern Texas. Then we get that trough coming in after that. And that's still pulling those other waves to the north anyway. So if you've never been here before, I've been talking about this trough coming in, the storm system. That's going to open up this pathway and let these storms come right into the Gulf. You can see the latest with the GFS, agreeing on that westward push, but also agreeing it will move over in time. And that's why that goes right into the Gulf and the next waves after that also. To show you the trend, look at the Canadian. It shows that it goes a little north of Jamaica, right over Haiti, Dominican Republic. Remember, north and east side will be the worst of the impacts. Goes over Cuba. Then it moves over, agrees that this high pressure moves over in time, and it goes right into the Gulf. Canadian takes it right towards Louisiana, potentially going again as a hurricane or a major hurricane. That is very concerning right there. The 96L showing that takes that westward jog right towards Mexico. Plus, you can take a look at the sea surface temperatures. There's nothing but heat and warm temperatures to help that system stay rapid intensifying. After Jamaica, it goes to a little bit cooler, but it's not too cold where it won't form. It goes from like 87, 88 degrees, 86 degrees, down to 83 or 84. All you need is 80 to sustain a system. Plus, you have the deep ocean heat content right here. So as it upwells from all its rotating, it will pull up that heat, and it will stay intensifying all the way to a major hurricane towards Yucatan Peninsula or towards Belize and into the Gulf, showing still a lot of warm waters, still above average. Just right north of the Yucatan and east is the only place where it's a little bit below average, but it's still warm temperatures. It's not like it's cold water. Showing the latest intensity guidance as it goes by 24 to 48 hours as it passes by the Lesser Antilles. Unfortunately, it definitely will be at least a Cat 2 or a major hurricane. Matter of fact, they are turning in more favor members towards a Cat 3 or stronger going across you. There is a few members showing it would just be a Cat 2. Either way, it will be a bad scenario. Then as it goes towards 4 days and beyond, going towards Jamaica, showing a Cat 2 or a major hurricane still coming your way. That as you go 5 days, as it goes towards the westward Caribbean, towards the Yucatan Peninsula, towards the Cayman Islands, it could be anywhere from a Cat 1 hurricane, maybe a little bit weaker, there's a couple members for that, or more likely will be a Cat 2 or strengthening. So you can see that tut did not hurt that wave at all. All this downgrading over here later, we will see all this move over in time. Showing the latest an automatic tropical cyclone forecast that it will be right past 72 hours going right towards Jamaica. So you are going to get that strengthening hurricane. And look, all of them are green. It will be below you, not that northward track like the Canadian is seeing, still going in that possible direction. But you also can see that being on that southern track for Jamaica also agrees it will take that westward track and not northward towards Cuba, towards the Louisiana shot. Remember that. This is showing that westward track right into the Bay of Campeche and strengthening up. When we take a look at the other members, you can see with the Canadian, still showing the latest deterministic. This is what we just saw on the run. But showing your average, this black line right here, more likely will take that western travel, go into the Bay of Campeche and threaten Mexico, threaten Texas, threaten Louisiana, and maybe Mississippi and Alabama. Okay, we'll be east side loaded. As you look with the latest with the European, you can see all the members agreeing more likely we'll take that westward track. It's almost set in stone, but not quite there yet. Anything can still change, but also agreeing that it will get into the Gulf, and look how it comes back down. Getting blocked by the high pressure still and showing a stall effect. And what happens after that? Not looking good. So far, showing it will go right back strong to a strong hurricane in the Gulf. All these members. Here's your strength and intensity right there. Now, when you go by the latest of the GFS, you can see the latest deterministic showing that run going right towards Texas. But when you look at your average, it's showing that it will go into that Bay of Campeche and maybe get that stall effect. I do believe we will see that westward track. It will threaten Jamaica. It will threaten Belize, the Yucatan, not only the Lesser Antilles. They already know from Mr. Weatherman that they have a lot coming their way. I believe this will track all the way into the Bay of Campeche, maybe be strong towards the Yucatan Peninsula, towards Jamaica, towards Belize, weaken down over some landfall interaction, and maybe strengthen back up again. What it does when it gets here is just too far to know. It could stall. It could wait and come back north. It could also go to the west. Latest from National Hurricane Center concurs. You'll see it will become that major hurricane all the way for the Lesser Antilles. You have the hurricane warnings and you have the tropical storm warnings out and a tropical storm watch. This is all about a matter of time. When it gets within a certain amount of period, the watches will turn into warnings. You see it has a major hurricane passing right towards Jamaica. This within 5 days. This section right here is the next 2 days. This is a 7 day run. This white one right here is a 5 day run. So you can see so far showing it will be that hurricane going in that direction. It could be on the north side. It could be on the southern side. As of right now, the chances for the rainfall to come with this system, you can see with the lighter green colors is 1 to 2 inches, but the darker green is anywhere from 2 to 4 inches. When you get to that yellow, that's getting towards 4 to 6 inches of rainfall. Also, when you're getting towards that darker orange color, that's going from the 6 to 8 inches, and the very dark, it's 8 to 12. A lot of heavy flooding coming. Barbados expecting 8+ locally, Grenadines 10+ locally, and maybe Grenada 6+ locally. Showing the earliest it could come towards you would be very early in the morning for tomorrow. So it's going to be later tonight and for tomorrow morning. Then as it goes towards Jamaica, we're talking about Tuesday evening coming your way, and maybe by Wednesday going towards the Cayman Islands. More than likely, time span will be around Monday, 8 a.m., sometime around 8 a.m. So in between midnight tonight and early in the morning, you need to be bunkered down in your safe place, have everyone as safe as possible. Just take all the precautions you can. Plus, as you go towards Jamaica for Wednesday morning, Tuesday night, Wednesday morning, you can expect it as well. Remember, these links are in the description for you so you can see the updates as they come out. Also, I have these links for you as well so you can see the winds and the rainfall. You can see the track with the Euro. You can see the latest track with the GFS on the winds. So far as wind gusts, showing it could be somewhere towards Kingstown, towards Hillsboro, and St. George's could get the bulk of the winds. Showing the strongest winds could be over 100 miles per hour. This will be stronger if this does intensify. Look how quickly it goes to 113. Then it starts getting even stronger. So the winds are showing in your direction. GFS is showing a little bit northward. Anyway, both of them are showing the Southern Antilles and Barbados, so please be aware of that. So far, Jamaica, the latest on yours shows it will be a little bit southern from you, according to the Euro. Bring a lot of strong winds down here, 136 miles per hour wind gusts. So far, not showing a lot of strong winds, but it's strong enough to create problems. You will have the flooding with this, and GFS is showing a direct hit. So maybe the winds will intensify even more for you. I will keep you updated. Remember, the links are in the description below. So far, the Cayman Islands are going to be okay. Going towards Belize, going towards the Yucatan Peninsula, bringing the stronger winds towards y'all according to the Euro. GFS takes that curve a little further to the north, But I believe that westward track, also with the rainfall, you can see the track with the rainfall, also with the Ural showing that westward track. So you can see for the Lesser Antilles, definitely bring a lot of heavy rainfall towards y'all with these storms. And for the southern side, whether it's GFS or Ural, showing a big hit on that flooding. So remember the amount that National Hurricane Center has showed. Remember that link is in the description below as well. You go towards Jamaica, showing with the Ural as it goes further south towards you, will be a lot of heavy flooding on the eastern and southern side. GFS, once again, takes it as a direct hit. Then not only with the winds, you could get the rain as well and be that life-threatening flooding mudslides for y'all as well. So please prepare for that. Remember, everyone, these links are in the description below. I cannot say that enough. That way you know what's coming. This goes towards Belize, Yucatan Peninsula. The only good news I can bring out of this is as you watch this track with the tropical cyclone forecast, you can see it is trending to go right towards Jamaica as you go towards 4 days. More likely towards Jamaica and northward and not on that southern side. And as it passes by, look at the grouping. Look how the grouping changes. So you have a more confidence that this will go to that westward track right into the Bay of Campeche, and a less of a confidence it will take that northern track. You have more members agreeing on that westward track. Then after that, who knows? It's still too far to know for sure. Matter of fact, we just got the live update. Remember, this is connected to the satellite. So you're going to see this information popping up soon across the internet. You get it first here. You can see the new track guidance potentially showing right towards Texas, right towards Louisiana, and one going where Siriaco went. But look at this. That's the latest information, everybody. I will keep you updated. I will do an afternoon update. Make sure you click that bell and select all. That's the only way you'll be notified. That's the new way YouTube is. That way it knows who's active and who's a ghost account, and they just get rid of the ghost accounts. That's why if you've been here before and you got to resubscribe, because you've been gone too long. Thank you for your time, everybody, and thank you to everyone that helps get this information to other people so that you can see what's going on, because as we all know, people need more than 2 or 3 days or 4 days just to prepare. Even a week is not enough when you got to get supplies, and you know how hard pricing been and how hard it's really been. Everything's 2 and 3 times the way it used to be just years ago. So thank you so much for helping getting this information out so other lives, other families could prepare. Thank you so much. I cannot say that enough. Now remember, God will protect you. Pray to him, believe in him, and have faith. He creates these. He can destroy these and change these. He will protect you. Pray to him. And if you haven't heard before, John 3:16-21. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in God. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I will keep you updated this afternoon on what's going on with this hurricane. I appreciate everybody. And remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. I know it's loud, but it's just funny.